Oh, that guy is good.
Oh, they also did the chiropractor, the doctor, she also did an adjustment.
Beautiful.
No,
but how hard was it?
Oh, it was pretty painful.
That shit was
painful. I don't like that.
I don't like it either.
But he loves it.
He said he even tells us to go harder. Yeah, my wife, same thing. My wife says, go harder, go harder.
Because, you know, I used to sleep on this side all the time, so I couldn't let my shoulder.
Yeah.
And I told him, and he just put his finger somewhere in here, and I feel like something cracked.
And he fixed it?
Right. Wow. Now I can move it. Rotator cuff. It's bad. I had a surgery on it.
Hey, your son's about to turn pro. Tell everybody his name.
His name is Eric Puente.
Eric Puente? What's his amateur record?
Oh, shoot, I don't know. He's got over 120 bouts, and I don't know. We have a few losses, you know. We got quite a bit, but, you know, it's like on amateurs, you can't win them all, unless you're Mayweather.
Eric Puentes, when you watch him, he looks like a fighter with already 7-8 pro fights. He doesn't
he's
look like
pro
an amateur.
February 2nd, right?
With top rank.
February 2nd, signed with top rank.
But you don't look like an amateur. You look like you've been fighting in the pros for a while. Did you fight in TJ, like 10 fights or something?
that didn't go count? On the record. Didn't go on the record.
Wait, so San Diego, we could walk to TJ and walk back.
Yeah.
Right?
You only got to pay, what, $500 to fight?
Yeah.
No.
And you get a good win.
Yeah, you got a mandatory win.
A lot of people do
They'll ask you, hey, what round do you want him to drop?
A lot of people do that. Did you watch the Mayweather sparring? Did you watch the Mayweather sparring?
I did.
What did you think? Easy win?
You know what? I thought it was... it was easy work, but it was kind
of
like...
Yeah, a lot of people say it was fake, but it wasn't fake.
To me, it was a joke. He looks small. That guy looks small as hell.
It was not a joke, it was not
fake.
You
can tell Mayweather has not trained. You can tell him this.
I think so. Legit. One to the body.
Kid fall, he's like all over the place.
Robert, he's 30 and 0. He got hit by a yoked out Mayweather.
He was crying.
He was crying with tears. He got fucked up.
Look. You know what? But I got to give it to him. At the end of the bout, I like what he said. You know what? It doesn't go on the record. Doesn't go on my record. All it was an exhibition.
But you know what? He was crying. He was pissed off because they told him that it was 3 rounds. So he thought that Mayweather was going to give him the 3 rounds and he knocked him out, so he got mad.
Remember, you're going to put banda for your grandma? Banda?
Oh, banda. We're just going to go over there, give her cake, whatever.
Cumpleaños de vuelta?
98.
Hoy.
98? Can you believe it?
Man, that's good.
How old is the big G?
74.
That's Texas. Pretty good bloodline.
98.
My grandma lived to 102.
That's badass. What's your secret? What was your secret?
Smoking cigarettes and drinking coffee every day. She wake up in the morning, she will make a dark coffee, no sugar, just dark coffee, a bread, and a cigarette. I'm like, hey, grandma, you gonna eat? No.
Was it a weed cigarette? Was it weed?
Probably.
My grandpa, my mom's dad, he died at 105.
What was his secret? Why did he live so long, Robert?
No,
did he have an easy life?
No, easy life in Mexico. Look, in Mexico, if you live in the country in Mexico, because the city is different. Yeah. But if you live in the country, you know,
you eat fresh.
Especially if you died at 105 and he died like, I don't even know, 10, 12 years ago. So he lived in the early 1900s. So. There's no water in your house, so you have to go to a fucking, you know, walk like half a mile away, carry fucking gallons of water to your house, to shower, to cook. You have to do that. You want to take a warm shower or you know, even for cooking, then they have no stoves. They have to go to the mountains, fucking chop leña, wood. They bring fucking bunches like that,
how did he stay healthy so many years?
Because a lot of walking, that's why.
It's organic.
A lot of walking, and everything he ate was, he would, you know, corn, tortillas, he would fucking grow his own corn. Beans, he would grow his own beans. Vegetables, he would grow his own vegetables. He ate, probably my grandpa probably never had a Big Mac, never had, you know, because he didn't even know what a hamburger was, because he lived in a ranch.
Robert,
all they eat is their, if they're going to eat once a week, they'll probably eat meat, they'll kill a chicken, and they'll have some chicken there, you know. Everything else.
Some dude bought a Big Mac, forgot it in his suit jacket, 13 years later, found it full intact, because the preservatives kept it, I swear, look it up, preservatives kept it perfect.
That's bad.
13 years.
That's bad.
Some guy bought a Big Mac, forgot it in his jacket, 13 years later, found it, and it still wasn't one piece.
No.
Yeah?
That's crazy.
They put stuff in there.
It's not bad, because it's that bad.
Yes, like so it doesn't go bad.
See, but like my grandpa, every day, or
fresh food.
Or they have their cows, yeah. Fresh milk, yeah. And they take them. You know, every day in the morning, they take them to the mountains. So they walk a couple of miles, they leave them over there by themselves, yeah. They come back, and then in the evening, they go back to pick them up. So that's it, they do that every day for fucking their whole life.
So no diseases, no modern life.
Yeah, everything, you know, everything they eat, everything they eat because they're growing their own stuff. That's the way it was, and still is, you know, if you go to one of those places that I'm telling you, country places, where the nearest town is an hour away, and it's a small little town where they're not gonna, there's no fucking McDonald's or KFC. None of that.
So that's 105 is a long time.
105.
Was he cool? Was he happy?
No, he was good. He was still
a jokester or serious?
No, he wasn't a jokester.
He was all business.
He was serious, yeah.
That's
but
your
he,
mom's
but
dad.
He was still, but he was still walking, still, you know, still doing his own thing. One day he just felt tired. He felt sick. Told his kids to come over.
And that's it.
Told him he
checked out.
Exactly, checked out, and that's it.
He didn't want to get old, too old. Yeah. That's crazy. So your grandmother's 98.
98 today.
It's amazing that her brain is still sharp.
Oh God, she fucking remembers everything.
Except, what do you tell me? She took a shower in the backyard, front yard, or something.
She broke her arm. So she only had one hand. So she couldn't go into the tub. She would fall, you know, into the
yeah,
shower.
Slip.
So my sister was supposed to go after she got out of work, whatever, to go shower her. When my sister got there, my grandma was in her back little patio with the hose fucking showering herself. Put a pinche manguera bañándose herself with a broken hand.
That's crazy.
And then another day they found her with the whole fucking, the cast, the everything. She fucking took it out just because it was too heavy or maybe itchy,
yeah,
whatever.
Yeah. She just took it off. Is she okay
she
now?
Took it off. She took it off and fucking threw it away. My sister's like, what happened to you guys? She's like, I took it off.
Gangster.
Solita se quitó el pinche yeso. Solita se quitó el yeso.
That's badass. So you guys gonna do anything for her birthday,
yeah,
Robert?
I'm gonna go right now after. I'm gonna go after
the workout.
After the workout, yeah.
But do you have anything planned or just to visit her?
Nah, just visit her. She's in a what? ¿Cómo se llama? Like a center where she's in rehab. Every day.
It's a convalescent hospital.
¿Cómo se llama?
Convalescent hospital.
Okay. Every day they're exercising her for her arm. You know, she's in therapy, like in
okay.
Rehab.
Yeah.
Doing every, you know, a lot of extras. So they have her there. For Christmas, they let my dad take her out. So
right.
My dad took her out.
Oh, okay.
And then brought her back.
That's
my dad.
Cool.
My dad goes everywhere.
Do they know who you are? Like the nurses and doctors when they see
yeah,
you?
Yeah,
the
workers. Okay. You know.
No, but like boxing
yeah,
fans. Some of them.
A lot. Yeah,
a lot of Filipinos.
A lot of them treat my mom, my grandma, really nice because of that.
That's good.
Oh, that's a good fight, Jose.
That's
she,
good.
Yeah.
She's
a
great fight, but honestly,
she's happy there, and
big guy, like,
and you know they take care of her really good.
And I'm really good.
That's good.